On the eve of World Cancer Day, it's been revealed Australia's most deadly cancers don't get enough funding for research. The good news, though, is that the industry is working to fix it.
In this room, Australia's cancer experts and top fundraising heads. And from today, they'll be working together a lot more.
Currently, our funding strategies are all very different, quite fragmented, and as a result, we have some discrepancies and imbalances in the research funding system.
And so the plan is now on paper to come up with a national strategy to share funding, avoid duplication, and fill the gaps.
If they do it as a group, then they can decide where the funding is most important to go, instead of being just, say, to breast cancer or to prostate. There's other areas that get very little.
Such as brain, pancreatic and particularly lung cancer. It's the most deadly, yet compared with more highly publicised types like breast cancer, receives just 1% of money raised.
Some cancers are perhaps a little bit stigmatised in the community.
The areas of brain and pancreatic and lung, they are attracting greater degrees of funding than they were 5 years ago. So we're on the right path.
However, cancer in general remains Australia's biggest killer, with more than 43,000 deaths in 2010 alone. It's also our most costly disease to fight, with more than 100,000 new cases diagnosed every year.
The new approach won't give priority to any one cancer. It's aimed at attracting more money and services for everyone.
Please have hope as a result of this.
Mazoe Ford, 10 News.